Indonesian President-elect Prabowo Subianto and his running mate, Gibran Raka Buming Raka, are set to be inaugurated this Sunday, marking the start of a government that could potentially have no opposition. Major political parties have joined the ruling bloc, leaving only a handful outside, raising concerns about the absence of a formal opposition.
With an eight-party alliance, Prabowo's legislative agenda is likely to pass smoothly. However, this has sparked fears of unchecked power in a country with a history of authoritarianism.
Karena orang kan banyak ragu sama Prabowo, karena dia kan dibesarkan oleh Pak Harto, dikenal sebagai orang yang mungkin punya masalah secara hak asasi manusia, tidak terlalu mendukung demokrasi dan sebagainya.
Prabowo plans to expand the government by adding 10 ministries and agencies, a move seen as creating senior positions for politicians in his coalition, including those from outgoing President Joko Widodo's former party, the Indonesian Democratic Party of Struggle, PDIP.
Kalau betul, itu semua diberi jatah menteri termasuk PDI Perjuangan, itu berarti untuk pertama kalinya pemerintahan ini sejak reformasi tidak ada partai yang menjadi oposisi atau partai yang berada di luar pemerintahan gitu. Nah, tentu pertanyaan menariknya adalah apa dampaknya nanti untuk pemerintahan ke depan kalau tidak ada oposisi, kalau tidak ada yang mengkritisi dari internal, ya dari internal DPR sendiri.
Jokowi leaves office facing criticism for allegedly attempting to change laws to benefit his family and using state bodies to suppress his opponents.